don't reinvent the wheel. Don't tell me what to do. In this video, I figure out why it took humanity so long to invent the wheel and see if these two can do it in a day.
Run me over.
This is a big problem for me.
It worked!
But first, I want to thank IBM for sponsoring this portion of the video. Now, when you think about the future of business and technology, you might think of faster computers and stacks of code. But that alone isn't going to solve our big problems. You see, we need to combine those things with creativity. Now, I'm not talking about creativity in the traditional sense of artists and musicians. No, I'm talking about developers, data scientists, and visionaries who are creatively applying technology in business to drive change. IBM calls them new creators. But what does that actually mean? Well, take Alejandro Blas, the director of Plataforma Tierra at Cajamar and the new creator. He is harnessing precise weather forecasts and AI to help Spanish farmers identify optimal irrigation and fertilization levels. But what does that have to do with creativity? Well, creativity is just being imaginative. And for Alejandro Blas, it's imagining more from the norm and not taking things for granted. So he took an industry that is thousands of years old and asked, how can we improve it using the tools we have today? It is so easy to perceive this divide between science and technology versus artistry and creativity. But I think that the problems that we solve in the world and in business would be better off if we realize that creativity and technology work better together. If you want to see more examples of that, check out IBM's YouTube channel or click the link in the description to learn more about the new creators. Thank you to IBM for sponsoring that portion of the video. Now back to the wheel. Now, I always thought that we weren't supposed to reinvent it because it's so simple and we should spend our time on more complex things. But no. It turns out the wheel was pretty hard to make. Parts of humanity were already in the Bronze Age, casting metal alloys, building sailboats, tuning their harps before we had the wheel. Those things sound more complex, so why did the wheel take so long? To figure it out, I wanted to rewind back to an age of ignorance and naivety, but that is really hard to do because time travel doesn't exist and wheels are everywhere. So I got the next best thing.
What do you guys know about wheels?
I'm just trying to eat my food, man.
Those are wheels. What do you know about them? We're making wheels!
Okay. Relax, relax.
I should probably explain what's going on here.
I wanted to see what would happen if I took two people with minimal pre-existing knowledge and zero preparation and asked them to invent the wheel. This is just a risk you face if you're friends with me. They were only allowed to use tools that were available at around 3500 BCE when the earliest records of the wheel first emerged. So basically these things. Immediate problem though.
Just one wheel. We did it. Cheers.
Wheels.
They don't know what the wheel is. Now, I don't know if this is common knowledge or not, but when people say reinventing the wheel, they don't just mean this round thing. I thought that was obvious, but when people say reinventing the wheel, they actually mean the wheel and axle. You know, the thing that makes it possible to fix a platform to rolling cylinders. Let me play that again, because I'm really proud of it. That is what I want Taha and Melissa to reinvent using only rope, wood, and some basic metal tools. Can they do that? Let's find out.
Okay, so my current plan is to take this box and add wheels to it. However, the attaching part is probably gonna be the hardest because, okay, I didn't wanna say anything because Melissa was still in the room, but this is what I'm actually gonna do.
I'm outside because I don't want Taha to hear me.
I'm gonna pull a rope across the middle of this and that'll act as my axle and then I'll tie it off on either side.
I know we gotta make a vehicle. I'm gonna make a raft with wheels, chariot on top. Wheels? Didn't think that one through enough. Okay, new plan.
I had one big wheel in the middle. I think that this will be really unstable, so potentially I will need four wheels rather than two.
Then we figure out a thing to attach these wheels together. I think it's time to go inside and decimate Taha.
Oh, this is really easy. I made a hole.
I think it's important that it goes in the middle, but I don't have any tools to measure if it's in the middle.
I've just noticed that on this multi-tool, there is a measuring device, which I can use to measure the circumference and diameter of my circle. Stuff I learned in maths. One, two, wait, I don't understand. One, two, three, stuff I learned in maths.
Oh, you know what? Now that I have this hole, I can measure it and make sure it's in the same spot.
So that is basically what I want to do. I don't know why it took so long to discover wheels. Seems pretty straightforward to me.
Wrong. Now, most of what I learned about the wheel comes from this book, The Horse, the Wheel, and Language by David W. Anthony. And let me tell you, it was not straightforward. As simple as the wheel might seem, the difficulty was in the details.
Before the wheel, difficult-to-carry objects were transported using things like waterways or sleds. In order to replace those options, the wheel needed to be more effective and easier to use. This is where things get tricky, because creating an efficient, moving, load-bearing wheeled vehicle is deceptively difficult. It seems there were two approaches to the problem. Fix the axle to the wheel and let them spin together, or fix the axle to a platform and allow the wheel to spin freely. Early examples of the spinning axle and wheel come from the Alps. The ends of the axle were square and plugged into the wheels, but the middle of the axle was cylindrical, allowing it to revolve under the wagon. This design was relatively easy to make, but it created a lot of drag, which lowered its efficiency. And that is probably why the fixed axle with free-spinning wheel design was more common in history. This design called for a lot of precision work, from a perfectly round axle to a wheel fit loose enough to turn, but snug enough not to wobble. Things like naves or hubs helped with the stability, but the technical accuracy needed to build it well was likely a major speed bump towards the invention of the wheel.
So you need to know that when it comes to a well-designed wheel, precision is key.
We're gonna wing it. But anyways.
You said that you had a plan.
I have a plan. It's a general idea.
It's like you asked a toddler to draw a car.
Wait a second. I just realized something. My current plan attaches these all together. If the wheel actually rolls, the whole thing will roll.
Killer. You're nailing it. Good job, bud.
I think I've done it. This is connected to this. So now,
I just need to do it again. But
a couple of problems I've ran into. I did not leave enough room.
Hey buddy, how's it going?
It's going great. Got my wheel. It's going.
You also have a very impressive hole. That's spinning.
And it spins. I was thinking like I need another one here, but it doesn't fit. So that's a future issue.
I think I've had a breakthrough.
What? You've had a breakthrough?
I was not confident. But I have discovered something.
You discovered the wheel. I've already made a wheel. I've actually made an engine as well.
Oh.
I invented the combustion engine. I can't tell if she's doing well or doing badly.
That was much easier than sawing it. I could have just snapped it. It's a pencil, not a block of wood. Yes! Yeah! I can't say that! It worked!
I need to add another wheel. I don't know how. You know what? What I have made is a horse-drawn carriage.
Maybe I need four of them. I'm gonna make two more of these, and I'm gonna try it with this one and cut four.
Sabrina.
What's up?
I have a question.
Hear me out. In the olden days, they would have had horses. If I create something that I can pull it along with, can I be the horse?
This couldn't have gone better. But it also couldn't have gone worse.
It's like I've scripted this. This is insane.
Okay, I swear I didn't script anything. It's just that, well, first you need to know that the thing that made the wheel go from a haha neat invention to a this is one of the most important things in the world is the fact that people didn't need to power it. We could transfer the work to animals. This also means that a major efficiency gain of the wheel was reliant on the domestication of oxen or horses, which could be another reason why it took so long. But anyway, this new possibility came with some challenges. The equipment used to attach an animal team to the wagon increased the weight and drag of the design. One way to correct for that was to use a strong but slim axle. By reducing the surface contact with the wheel, the cart would experience less drag. However, if the axle was too slim, it could bow or snap. An alternative was to remove a pair of wheels and make a cart. They experienced less drag and were easier to maneuver. They just had a lower carrying capacity. So, you see what I mean by this feels scripted, right? Like, Melissa had slim but strong axles, so she could make a wagon. But Taha couldn't figure out how to keep his vehicle structurally solid with multiple axles, so he made a cart. I just think it's neat that this happened entirely unintentionally. But now let's see which one's better.
I think I'm supposed to have string. Did Taha steal it? Now, we do this. The wheels on the tractor go round and round. Am I right? All right, I'm gonna need some string, I think.
He has it.
I'm gonna get it from him.
I think I was just robbed.
Doing something. Now I just have to figure out how to connect them together. What I'm gonna do is tie them together with string.
No! Look what happened.
Oh. Sew them through the hole.
I made a snap. Perfect.
I think I have finished my wheeled vehicle. I'm gonna go for a walk. I think I've gotten into a bit of a weird space.
I basically am done. I've got my little drawstring where the horse would go. I've got my little guy. Wait, I have one last thing to add.
So, I made something. I have no idea how Taha is doing. I hope he's doing okay.
I've made my guy. He's over here. His name's Terry.
I went into this not very confident, and I don't think I had much of a plan at all. I'm quite proud of my little monstrosity.
She did say that we were allowed to push it along, and I feel like, what is pulling along if not a genre of push?
And by some stroke of luck, the pencils were the magical lifesaver that we didn't know we needed. That was actually so crazy. When I saw those pencils, I felt an actual light bulb go off in my head, and I thought I was the smartest thing I've ever done.
I like this variable for different sized horses. Other than that, I had a vision and I set out to do it and then I got it done.
Sometimes that's all you need. Some stuff and some constraints and some people to...
This is a competition. Only one of you leaves this house alive.
Make you make stuff against your will.
So we'll see, but Taha and Terry are the dream team and I'll die for him. I will literally pass away.
It's day two. Time to see who is better. Can you close your eyes?
Okay.
No.
Please?
Okay.
Ready? Open your eyes.
Yours is bad.
Oh, you got a little smiley face. You made a little tractor wheelbarrow situation.
Yeah, it's Terry.
I think Melissa doesn't know what a tractor is.
Whoa, how did you get the holes to be so big? Did you just stab it with a pencil?
Yes. No, I'm kidding.
Did you use tools?
Yeah.
Okay.
What was your thought process here?
Well, in the olden days, they had horse and carriage, so this is the horse area.
Are you guys ready to start with challenge one?
Me and Terry could never be readier.
This is my tractor.
The competition is made of three challenges based on the societal significance of the wheel, starting with, does it have wheels? We know it took so long to invent the wheel because of how hard it is to attach a rolling object to a platform while keeping everything stable and efficient. So whoever attaches their wheels better wins the round.
Taha, you're going first. You and Terry.
Hello.
You just need to prove that he could travel with moving wheels.
Objection. The friction on the surface is not regulation. Whee! Yeah! Woohoo!
I've grown very emotionally attached to Terry.
Okay, let's see Melissa's.
I don't have anything to pull it with. I just have to push it. You ready? Wait.
I can't believe yours works.
I have an idea. You could hold on to the back of mine.
You two do know this is a competition, right?
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's adorable.
Yeah, but who wins? Is it Terry, the sweet little Terry boy, or
the dump tractor?
See, here's the thing. Melissa deserves it.
Okay, Melissa got it. Let's
okay.
go.
Okay. Boo.
On to challenge
rigged.
Two.
Rigged. Rigged. Okay. It's rigged. Write in the comments. Rigged.
Stop it. Get away from me.
All right. Challenge two. Does it transport? Wheels made shelter, water, and food portable in a way that wasn't possible prior. This allowed shepherds to grow and disperse their pastures across the Eurasian steppe, likely spreading wheel technology in the process. So whoever safely transports an egg to the finish line faster wins the round.
You guys ready to race?
This is not gonna go very well.
Yo, Terry looks mad ready, bro.
Yeah, he's revving his engine.
In 3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah!
My wheel's falling off!
Yeah! Yeah! Woohoo!
I think that I need a minute.
You know, me and Terry always knew this was gonna happen. We've been training for a really long time. Our regimen was extremely precise and we just showed up on the day and
you
gave it all we
could. You failed me!
I think we'll do even better next season. We've got some good sponsors lined up and the funding's there. I think Terry's got it.
Run me over.
Time for the final round. Strength.
The carrying capacity of wheeled vehicles was a game changer. Beforehand, heavy loads could only be moved through waterways and by large coordinated groups. The wheel made it possible to carry such loads across land more efficiently. And since things are tied, whoever carries more weight wins the game.
So I just put these on?
Yeah.
And whichever one breaks first is the loser?
Correct.
102 grams. What a strong boy.
I don't know if you're gonna be able to fit more than two on there.
So we'll use a different method.
What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Terry had a little bit of sag.
I have the suspension.
Terry's holding strong. Okay, I want to find more things to put on Terry. Would you like a bunch of applesauce?
This seems ill-advised.
Terry's butt is about to touch the ground.
Oh.
Nah.
The moment Terry's tushy touches the ground, it's over.
1.8 kilograms. Can Terry do 2 kilograms?
Ooh.
2.06 kilograms.
Hey. Is nothing touching the floor yet?
I'm suspicious of this.
What?
I guess he's always touching the floor at the front.
Can I lift him up? Okay. So all the weight is on the wheels now.
Tried to sabotage my vehicle. I'm not confident in mine.
I'm not confident in my system.
All right, on the scale. I hope these wheels don't fall off again.
I believe.
All right.
One.
Got 112.
112. 228.
Oh yeah.
340.
This is the worst auction I've ever
attended. How am I gonna put more of them?
866. I think you just put the whole bowl. Alrighty, let's go.
I will say at this point, Terry was sagging a little. This thing looks like it could just keep going.
How dare you. Say that to Terry's face. You can carry Terry as well. I admit defeat. Congratulations.
Thank you, thank you. You have very soft hands, by the way.
So, that is why it took humanity so long to invent the wheel, but also how even with advanced knowledge and tools, we can run into the same pitfalls and even arrive at the same conclusions as people thousands of years ago, which just goes to show that the saying might be true. Maybe we shouldn't reinvent the wheel. But what we should do is comment, like, subscribe, but either way, have a lovely day.